I've got Titus Pierce on the line, who is a candidate for governor. Titus, thanks for joining me on New Jersey 101.5. Good morning.
Good morning. How's everybody doing today?
Well, we're doing great, Titus. And I should ask you, first of all, how's your car doing? I know your car broke down, the transmission. Is it back?
It's not back yet, Bill.
Oh, come on. All right. So you're still walking?
Still walking into New Jersey Transit.
All right. All right. Good. So here's the question. You sent out a tweet the other day. And your quote was that you wish blacks would get over slavery. Now,
absolutely.
Tell me what you mean by that, because you were responding to the racial tension that is discussed on the Princeton campus with regard to Woodrow Wilson.
Correct.
All right. So
and
tell me what you meant.
I'll just be frank and clear. You know, African Americans, we just have a large social stigma, not what society has put on us, but what we've put on ourselves. In terms of what slavery has done to our individual subculture. And it is really a degenerative thing. I'm talking where people get up every day and, you know, say in their, you know, in their minds, I'm not going to go to college. I don't want to be a part of a union. Only thing I want to do is, you know, just get, you know, ahead in America by going to work or just getting quick money. And, you know, what I would like to impress upon every African American that may not have an education or may not have had the sound, you know, a strong foundation is that education, that knowledge, those experiences are what allows you to get those jobs and hit the requisites to get larger salary cards and things
so
like that.
So why, so Titus, why reference slavery? Do you think people are hung up on the past? I mean, what's your message?
Bill, every day, you know, I come out here and I campaign for governor. I'm African-American. I go into some of these communities and the first thing I hear is, sounds like this is all for white people. I was in Newark, literally, and I was talking to some folks out in Weequay. And yeah. I said, we're building a 62-story building over on Lombardi Street once I get into the office. I said, 62 towers will be the largest in Newark's history, the largest building in the state. They really looked at me and said, that's not going to do anything for our community. And I said, absolutely wrong. You know, there are freight elevator operators. There are people who operate the decks. Almost every floor needs assistance and people inside that may not have a degree. But because there is no real education or no fresh blood or fresh knowledge coming into that community, it's just a slavery mentality. Like, you know, the neighborhoods have become the new modern plantation. And I want everyone off.
Wow. I mean, those are all right. So how do you what's your message to these kids on campus that are fighting over Woodrow Wilson? You strike his name, you keep it.
You know, what my message is to the high school people is you're not there to fight. You're not there to be in a popularity contest. You're there to get an education, to go and exit the high school with a diploma, go to college in a capitalism society and produce and be a capital producer and pay your taxes and drive on. And the intention here is to get more every year, more than you had before.
All right. So, Titus, let me ask you, are you getting any traction out there? I mean, are people responding to you? Have you reached out to the other potential gubernatorial candidates on the Democrat side who you're going to compete with in the primary?
Absolutely not. I don't reach out to them about what we're going to do from a policy standpoint because I got to beat them, and I am beating them. My policy, and that's why I'm 10-0 in these political businesses, is to pretty much stay hands off and far away from the other candidates as we try to beat them up and bludgeon them up along the way.
Wait, what do you mean 10-0?
I've been in 10 political contests since 1997, yeah. From everything from student council presidents all the way up to class presidents and senators, whatever. No matter what the political climate, whether no matter what the campaign, I always come out victorious.
All right. You're the New England Patriots of New Jersey politics. 10-0. All right, Titus, I appreciate you joining me on New Jersey 101.5. You and I will certainly stay in touch, and good luck. And I'm hoping the next time we talk, the car will be back. Keep me posted.
No doubt about that. Happy Thanksgiving to
yeah,
you
too.
Happy Thanksgiving to all of New Jersey and America.
All right. Happy Thanksgiving, Titus. We'll